Hi, I'm Henry from Boston Manor, and you're listening to Total Rock.
Or of Total Rock at Rockham Ring, and today I have the honor of sitting with Henry of Boston Manor, all the way from the UK, gonna rock and make everyone emotional on stage in just a couple of minutes. How are you doing today, Henry?
I'm doing really well. How are you doing?
You sound very calm.
I am calm, yeah.
Okay, that's great. I love the shades as well.
I'm relaxed. Well, it's sunny outside, you know? It's
surprising. You don't jinx it. You know, you're coming from the UK. We're not allowed to talk about the weather because it changes.
We're also obsessed with talking about the weather. It occupies our every waking thought and we need to talk about it at all times.
Especially coming from the sunny beach town of Blackpool, you have to talk about the weather. But let's talk about the music, if you don't mind. First of all, is it your first time at Rockham Ring, Rockin' Park?
It is, yeah. We've never played before, so I'm really excited.
Okay. How is it feeling? Is it something that you looked up to? I think that even in the UK, it's on TV, so people know the festival. Have you attended something like that as a fan?
Never this festival. I mean, I remember watching like Metallica sets and thinking, that's a lot of people. That's a really, really big festival. I mean, it's definitely one of those. If I could have come to it as a kid, I probably would have done, for sure. We've been looking forward to it for, well, since we got asked to play it. We're really looking forward to it.
And I don't know how true this bit of information is, but there's a rumor that you guys speak German fluently. Is that true?
Nein, it's not true. Me and Ash studied German in school, but language is crap in the UK, so you know, I can ask for a coffee and say please and thank you and stuff, but I'm not fluent in German at all, unfortunately. But you know, maybe I'll get Duolingo and see you next time we come. Maybe we'll have this conversation in German.
But I bet you know at least one kind of saucy phrase that you're not supposed to say next to your grandma.
I don't know if I do. You know, I know like lots of really boring stuff, but I don't know if maybe you could teach me one.
Okay, maybe after the camera is off, we can go.
Okay, cool.
But I feel like everybody knows at least one really bad thing in a different language that they should not say next to their family members.
I mean, Scheiße, everyone knows that, right? But I don't know if I know anything in German that's particularly saucy. I know how to ask where the town hall is, you know?
Again, sassy and useful. Okay, you guys just announced that you're going to be joining Alexis on Fire on tour. They're pretty heavy. Are you planning already to start a mosh pit? Is it something that kind of went back to the band as a discussion topic?
Oh, bro, you know we don't need to have a discussion about that. It's on the itinerary at all times, you know? It'll be an absolute riot. I can't wait. You know, you'll see us out there. We get people jumping around and stuff and moving about. I mean, that's kind of the aim of the game with especially festivals like this. You know, it's you only have 30 minutes, 45 minutes. You want to create as much carnage as possible in a short space of time. So that's what I'm here for. You know, that's my role. I can't play an instrument. I'm not a musician. I'm just a guy with a big mouth and a microphone. So
do you know how to promote a mosh pit in German? That's important here.
Teach me. How would I say, I want to see the biggest fucking mosh pit?
I think you can say that.
Yeah.
I think even if nobody speaks English, just say mosh pit or pogo.
Yeah,
that
pogo
works.
Okay. Yeah, sick. Okay.
Okay. Well, we'll see that in a couple of minutes. I want to talk about the lyrics. Your latest single is called Foxglove.
Mm-hmm.
And it's about losing control. And I'm guessing it's partially about what happened over the last 2-3 years, maybe something a bit more personal. But what do you do when you lose control? How do you gain control? How do you go back to being positive? If at all, you just maybe stay negative and just accept that of not being okay.
I think I struggle sometimes with the idea of feeling like I don't have a grip on my actions, or maybe not so much my actions, but my kind of choices or certain sort of situations that I'm in. And when I feel like I'm not in control, I kind of freak out a little bit. I'm one of those people that's I'm pretty easygoing, but in certain situations, if I don't have a grip on that, I start to panic and I start to spiral quite a lot. And one thing I'm trying to work on is getting myself out of that and kind of putting the brakes on that spiral. And I'm lucky. I've got great friends that look after me and a wonderful fiance who's very good at kind of taking care of me when I need to be taken care of. But yeah, it's difficult. That song's actually about drinking, about having no control with drinking and realizing that you've not got a grip on that kind of thing, you know.
I'm guessing they both relate, like the personal and then getting drunk and then the personal. So it can take it to wherever you want.
Completely intertwined, yeah, they're the same thing. I always try and write stuff from a perspective that anybody could apply their own struggle to that lyric, you know. I'm not directly saying it's about drinking or drugs or mental health, but you know, the idea being that people who feel out of control in whatever situation can latch onto that, you know.
And I found it maybe even ironic as a fan. Obviously we got exposed to the darker side of your music over the last couple of years, even as fans, but I found it ironic that I really enjoyed Glue and I really enjoyed Desperate Times that was released last year. So for me, it just felt like you guys are getting better and better and bigger and maybe even more positive. And then Foxglove came out and it felt to me like it touches on kind of the imposter syndrome. Is it something that you relate to?
That's actually great that you picked up on that. That's 100% something that I really struggle with. Even having this interview here now, you know, sometimes I feel like, what am I doing here? You know, why are they asking me questions? Like, I'm so regular, you know? So, yeah, for sure. And I'm actually quite a shy person. I don't seem like it, but I have to kind of go into a little place in my head sometimes to get that sort of confidence. It's the imposter syndrome is all part of that for sure. Thank you for the kind words about the records. I think generally we are in a really positive place. I think as we're getting older, we're kind of having more tools to deal with some of the kind of things that when we were young, kind of fucked up kids, we didn't really know how to deal with, and we were pretty destructive, and you can kind of hear a lot of that in the music as well. But I think as we get older, we are understanding things more, and at least my outlook on the world has changed. You know, I'm not as nihilistic as I used to be, and I do think that things can get better, both individually and collectively. I'm trying to rein in. I'm trying to not beat people over the head with a misery stick too much, you know, because it can get a little tiring. But it's been a dark couple of years, you know. So we're just kind of coming out of that now. But a lot of the darkness of this new music we're releasing, and of that record particularly, Desperate Times, Desperate Pleasures, is just when I was just sitting at the bottom of a pretty big well, black pit.
So you're kind of leading me to my next question, because Desperate Times touched on kind of that social decay, and I'm guessing, again, it was affected by the last 2 years. I was in the UK as well, so I know where society was kind of all over the place. But do you feel like... You kind of touched on that, so I'm guessing the answer. But do you feel like, again, it's going to get better? You're a bit more hopeful?
We talked for about 3 or 4 hours in the van driving here about this. Just had a big discussion about particularly the UK and where things are at. And I think it's a very scary time. I think we're running the risk with our government of losing control of a lot of our liberties and a lot of our freedoms and a lot of our... dignity in a lot of senses, and I think we need to be very careful about the decisions we make politically, because right now the British people are being made fun of by its government, and people are starving, quite literally having to choose between heating or eating, and everyone's at home fucking celebrating a multi billionaire who quite frankly hasn't done jack shit for the British people. So I personally am not taking part in any Jubilee celebrations, and I think it's a bit it's not an appropriate time to be partying in the street for a billionaire when, you know, people literally can't put the heating on in their house and stuff. So yeah, that stuff is very bleak. However, I think we've never had a more engaged youth. We've never had more people more vocal and more able to share information about stuff, not letting the government and get away with things, and also kind of like helping each other, because the where I'm at now is the government ain't going to help my community that I live in. I live in one of the poorest areas in the country, and it's up to me and the platform that I have with this band to try and do what little I can to help my peers, because that's all we can do at this point, help ourselves, because we're not being helped by a crooked shambolic government. But I am hopeful, because I think things will get better, definitely. I can see the little tiny pinprick of light at the bottom, at the end of this tunnel, but I think we're headed towards it.
Is the end of the tunnel just Paris? Just
yeah, pretty much, yeah. We're all just gonna bail.
I didn't think that you expected this kind of conversation to have in a chat that started with some Haribos.
We went there.
I want to confront you with a rumor. If I'm not mistaken, you were all raised in a suburb of Blackpool, and there's a rumor that I guess started after Welcome to the Neighborhood was released in 2018.
Yeah,
that the tourism office contacted you and tried to use Welcome to the Neighborhood to promote Preston.
Is that true? No, that's not true at all, but that's really funny. I've never heard that before. But honestly, if anyone from the Blackpool Tourism Board is watching this, which I very much doubt they are, hit me up. I'd love to be involved. Like, I rep Blackpool all day. Like, I never shut up about it. And I'll score your little adverts for, you know, summer holidays and stuff. I'll be an ambassador, you know. I would love to do stuff. We're trying to do more stuff with Blackpool. We want to do a big show there and stuff. And we were actually in the process of building like a festival there, but the pandemic kind of fucked all that up. But up the pool and down with Preston North End.
Yeah, let's talk about the future. We already mentioned you got a tour with Alexis on Fire. You are doing a set at Rock'em Ring. Rocking Park already happened yesterday?
No,
tomorrow.
Yeah.
And I heard an interview from the release of Glue that you guys said that you recorded 2 albums worth of material. So what is happening in the future of Bossa Manor?
Well, it's top secret. I can't tell you anything, man.
Just pointing out, just the two of us here, just, okay? Nobody's listening.
I'd say just keep your eyes, on your browser. Get your algorithm pushing Bossa Manor stuff at you for the next couple months, and maybe you'll see some cool shit is all I will say. But for now, my lips are tightly sealed, my friend. I can't give too much away. But it's exciting. We got stuff happening. We've been very busy throughout all the pandemic and until now, you know.
Henry of Bossa Manor, thank you much for sharing, opening up about your social mental health and about our society as well, and about the music. So I'm really excited about seeing you on stage again after a couple of years. It's been a while. So thank you very much for sharing.
My pleasure.
It's been a pleasure.
Thank you so much. Cheers.